this is an interesting discussion because we talk about digital first, and India's digital first is very unique compared to the rest of the world, where we still have the traditional platforms going very strong, if not growing, as you said. So if I have to start straight away, I want to ask, Milind, I want to start with you straight away in the interest of time. Is India's digital first approach different from the rest of the world? Should it be different the way it has to be contextualized in the way our media, traditional media functions? Just want to start with it from you.
So, Rohil, thank you very much mujhe bulane ke liye. Aapne jo pucha sawal ki, I'll speak in Hindi if you don't mind.
Sure.
So, aapne sawal pucha ki digital first ka jo approach hai hamara India ka, wo kaisa hai aur wo kya sahi hai, galat hai. तो सबसे पहले तो आप अपने जो ऑडियंस है उसी को देख लीजिए, जो यहाँ भी बैठे हुए हैं वो सब मोबाइल फ़ोन पे लगे हुए हैं. तो इसका मतलब ये है कि सब लोग डिजिटल पे ही अपना कंटेंट कंज्यूम कर रहे हैं. तो मुझे ये लगता है कि जब ऑडियंस ऑलरेडी हमारा जा चुका है डिजिटल पे, सो अब हम ये बहस कर रहे हैं कि वेदर वी शुड बी डिजिटल फर्स्ट एंड वॉट इज़ द डिजिटल फर्स्ट दैट पुट योर कॉन्टेंट फर्स्ट ऑन डिजिटल इंस्टेड ऑफ से अ न्यूज़पेपर और अ टेलीविजन स्टेशन. सो I am saying that we are past that stage. अब ये रट जो है डिजिटल फर्स्ट की मैं पिछले 10-12 साल से सुन रहा हूँ, मुझे लगता है कि इसका समय जा चुका है, क्योंकि जो कंजम्पशन हो रहा है वो ज़्यादा अब हो रहा है डिजिटल पे. एंड एज अ जर्नलिस्ट, एज अ न्यूज़ रूम, वी हैव टू ऑल चेंज एंड डू द कॉन्टेंट वेयर आवर ऑडियंस इज. नाउ हाउ द इंडियाज अप्रोच इज़ डिफरेंट वर्सेज अदर्स इज दैट इंडिया में हमने ये किया है ज़्यादातर न्यूज़ रूम्स ने कि जो अखबारों के न्यूज़ रूम्स हैं उन्होंने एक अलग से न्यूज़ रूम क्रिएट कर लिया डिजिटल के लिए, इंस्टेड ऑफ दोज न्यूज़पेपर जर्नलिस्ट वर्किंग फॉर डिजिटल. और टेलीविजन जर्नलिस्ट का भी एक न्यूज़ रूम है और एक डिजिटल न्यूज़ रूम है. सो ये एक तरह से यूनिक इसलिए है कि बाकी जो दुनिया में जो अच्छे एग्जाम्पल्स हैं वहाँ पर जो अखबार के जर्नलिस्ट हैं या वो टी वी के जर्नलिस्ट है, दे आर producing for various platforms. They are not just producing for one platform, which is, say, TV, radio, or akhbar ke liye. So I think this is our approach is unique because, as you pointed out, that newspapers still continue to make money, TV still continues to make money. So we thought, why not invest into a digital newsroom? That's why we are different than others. But I don't think this can last long, or the publishers for a long time can afford to have three different newsroom, one for say text, one for video, and one for digital.
Prerna, is being on digital like enough? Like he said, in this room people are on digital, is that digital first enough, or there is a filter needed for the credibility? Is speed the only factor needed in being digital first?
Well, speed is one of the factors, because you see, if you look at it, if you look at the digital first phenomena, it's not anymore a nice to do thing. It is a necessity. So it's not as if we started a disruption because the industry decided to do something. It's just that the consumer has changed. You know, the consumer preference has changed. The consumer is ubiquitous in connectivity, wants ubiquitous connectivity. The consumer wants portability. They want to carry their content with them. They want to carry their world with them. They cannot be fed information which is yesterday's or 3 hours delayed. So obviously speed is a factor, because the new Gen Z and millennial profile does not have the patience or the tolerance to wait for hours to be delivered content. But more than, you know, if you come to the verification bit of it, yes, it's very important. And that is where I think there is a difference between the legacy media houses and the new ones. Because the legacy media houses can actually capitalize on their existing verification mechanism, you know. For example, in our own group, we, of course, have the normal verification mechanism because we have regional reporters and we have a very big network of stringers. But we also had to do a little bit of fine-tuning to our systems and processes. We had to add a news verification desk on the digital, which is the anti-fake news desk. We also had to do a digital intelligence unit, which constantly, a data intelligence unit, which constantly works on data to verify stuff real time on the ball. So I think, you know, it's not one versus the other. It is speed plus the verification, which is very important in the digital scenario.
Before I come to you, Loreno, one more question for you, Milind. a famous known TV journalist told me that digital is because of television, because as soon as my show comes on air, you see the trends going on Twitter. I mean, how would you explain this kind of an
situation? There is what Prerna works is, I mean, so television thinks that Twitter or a Facebook or a social media is a second screen. So people are watching something on TV and then they react on another screen, which is their mobile screen. That is the phenomena. But I will not be able to pass a judgment on like who's driving whom. Because, I mean, when you heard in the previous panel that anchors, before they go for a show, they are tweeting that, you know, watch my show, or, you know, promoting their shows on Twitter, which means their audience is there. Otherwise, you know, if their audience is not sitting directly in front of the TV, then they don't need to promote so much of their show on the Twitter, which means that their audience is sitting there. Another point is that in the morning, Navika, I saw her clip where she is saying that, you know, one of her clip has gone viral and how many 100K on Twitter it has got. So I think, I mean, somewhere even the measurement of success for television anchor has become that how much it is being watched on Twitter or a YouTube or... So maybe their content is not changing, but their consumption is clearly, people are watching that TV on the digital. So we again heard Bhupen this morning that how an editor would get angry over reacting to the Twitter trends. So these Twitter trends were not created by journalists. They were created by maybe political parties or by the influencers. So, I mean, they are feeding into each other, I would say. That the TV is feeding into the social media and the Twitter is feeding into the mainstream media. I mean, I don't know what is your view.
Prerna, once again. So in the newsroom, tell us about the real situation inside the newsrooms. How important has the digital piece become? For example, a couple of days back, in the morning, we saw a Delhi police video and the entire narrative, the agenda was set by that one video, which was out on Twitter. How important is this piece for the traditional power of your organization?
You know, we might want to kind of duck our head in the sand and say we are still all powerful and we are the media and we decide the national narrative and the news narrative of this country. But I beg to differ, because it is the time for citizen journalism now. And, you know, when you see most of the news agenda for the day for any newsroom today, and I can say this with a lot of confidence, is that it is usually decided by probably a small clip which has gone viral, where somebody has recorded some atrocity in action, or somebody has recorded some celebrity or a politician acting in a particular way. If you were to go through the realms of conventional media, I think that would not have even figured into the national discourse maybe 7 or 8 years ago. But now, when you sit in the newsroom for the meetings, you first take a look at what the citizen is trying to tell you. And I think that's what should be the prima facie objective of a media house. They should be looking at what the citizen is saying and what they are trying to tell you, and then build a narrative around it, rather than having a top-driven thing where I have a message, this is my story of the day, you like it, fine, you don't like it, walk away. Now it is more like building all that conversation which is happening on various platforms into your broadcast, especially. And it's a two-way street. You know, we have lots of packages which the digital creates, which find their way into the broadcast or the prime time of the day. So I think it is the time for citizen journalism, and I think it'll be nice if the media kind of bows and says, yes, we accept that.
Lorena, my first question to you. So Lorena also was part of a 100-year-old publication in Argentina, if I'm right,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Give us the outside perspective. I mean, how is digital conversation, digital first conversation, shaping up outside India, especially in your country?
Okay, well, first I'll give you a brief of an example of the 100 years newspaper, no? So in 1898, my great-grandfather founded a newspaper. It was called La Nueva Provincia, which means the new province. Because at that time, he was not only an entrepreneur, but a visionary. At that time, they used a newspaper to get territory. You know, imagine this was the most important newspaper in the south of the province of Buenos Aires. Perhaps you have heard about Patagonia. It's like the Kerala of Argentina. Okay? So it was a really important newspaper. The record in sellings were around the 1965 and the 1970s. But after that, television came up to a scene. So at that time, they realized that people were expecting fresh news. And then a daily publication was not enough. So they start like working also in television and multimedia. But after a few years, internet came into a scene. So they again need to adapt to the reality of the needs of the consumers. And at that time, was quite hard to like manage all these different platforms. And the reality was, as a regional like newspaper, the worst issue that they faced was regarding to advertisement. Of course, you cannot be a competitive regarding to Google Ads, no? So after a few years working on the internet like level, let's say, like we start the online platform on 2005 was the first experience, the pilot project, but the real one was in 2013. But 3 years ago, we sold the newspaper. That is the reality. And now the family business is regarding to optic fiber and internet.
But India is a very different story still, right? India continues to be a different story. I mean, with all due respect, what's happening there? I have another question. So what has also happened with digital is first or second or third, but digital, first word, is that all these issues of fake news and what the words we heard, WhatsApp University and all, it's also a product, byproduct of digital. So while being practicing and advocating the digital first strategy, you also have a huge responsibility of coming to terms with these issues. And how do you kind of own this responsibility in the digital space and come to terms with it and correct it?
So, I mean, digital is being blamed for the fake news. But I think what has happened is that fake news, to my mind, always existed in the society. It has got a better amplification now, you know, because of the connectivity of the WhatsApp. And no, I mean, I have heard this so many times, but I mean, I will ask all of you, are we better off with the connectivity or without connectivity? So we have seen places in the country where, I mean, internet...
Better connectivity and more fake news or less?
No, I'm not talking about... I'm saying that while the fake news is being... Like, what do you want? That connectivity... internet will be closed for 1 hour, या सिग्नल नहीं मिलेगा तो हम परेशान हो जाते हैं. तो हम हर चीज़ के लिए ब्लेम कर रहे हैं कि भाई डिजिटल की वजह से फेक न्यूज़ बढ़ गई है. मेरी नज़र में फेक न्यूज़ सोसाइटी में हमेशा थी. कभी वो ज़बानी ही चलती थी. सईद वहाँ बैठे हुए, हमारे इंदौर में एक किस्सा था कि भाई लोगों ने कहना शुरू कर दिया, चल गई और पूरे दुकानें बंद हो गई शहर में. तो लोगों ने बाद में पूछा भाई क्या चला, तो बोला कि खोटी चवन्नी चल गई. तो बात यह है कि पेम्पलेट है, अखबार है, ये सब चीज़ें अब चूंकि उसको एक प्लेटफॉर्म मिल गया, उसको एम्पलीफाई हो रहा है. तो ऐसा नहीं है कि फेक न्यूज़ पहले नहीं थी, उससे लड़ने की ज़रूरत है. और जैसा प्रेरणा ने कहा, हर आदमी लड़ रहा है, हर जो भी प्लेटफॉर्म है, जो भी रिस्पॉन्सिबल प्लेटफॉर्म है, वो हर कोई फैक्ट चेक कर रहा है. वैसे तो फैक्ट चेक करना, बिना कोई खबर, बिना फैक्ट चेक किए हमको छापना नहीं चाहिए. मतलब हमारा एज ए पत्रकार के तौर पर हमारी जिम्मेदारी ये है कि हम बिना फैक्ट चेक किए छापे ही ना. लेकिन चूंकि कोई कोई वेस्टेड इंटरेस्ट ग्रुप्स हैं जो उसको प्रोपोगेट करते हैं, चाहे वो हेल्थ को रिलेटेड हो या पॉलिटिकल रिलेटेड हो, तो उसको आप उसको डीबंक ही कर सकते हैं बियॉन्ड दैट. और मुझे लगता है कि जो बाकी प्लेटफॉर्म्स हैं, सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म है, कल ही मैंने कोई खबर पढ़ी कि सब मिलके वापस से कोई चीज़ कह रहे हैं. जैसे फेसबुक पे वो कह देते हैं कि ये स्टोरी फेक है, मतलब दे विल लेबल इट एज फेक न्यूज़. व्हाट्सएप अभी तक कुछ कर नहीं पाया. तो अब ये है कि ये समस्या है और हमको इससे लड़ना चाहिए, लेकिन इसलिए हम ये ना कहें कि डिजिटल को ही किल कर दीजिए.
प्रेरणा, व्हाट आर द यूनिक चैलेंजेस ऑफ डिजिटल फर्स्ट अप्रोच दैट यू हैव टू फेस ऑन एन एवरीडे बेसिस इन योर न्यूज रूम?
यू नो, आई थिंक द बिगेस्ट चैलेंज प्रॉब्ली व्हिच वी सॉ कमिंग आवर वे इन दिस डेकेड वाज द एडवेंट ऑफ सोशल मीडिया एज अ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर न्यूज. And to Milind's point, I think that has become one of the biggest pain points, even for the social media platforms now, because while they thought they were democratizing news and putting news on their platforms, they did not realize that it comes with a lot of responsibility. And if you don't have a credible name or a credible, you know, team working behind that news dissemination, it actually led to all this fake news nonsense that we are seeing today. And I, though I work in the area and I should not be saying this, but, you know, using social media as a news consumption practice or lifestyle is what has led us into this thick mess right now. You know, you see what happens. You know, there are Jamia videos from the police. There are Jamia videos from the students. So the journalist is completely left rudderless to understand and has to spend triple the amount of energy and time on verification of those videos, because speed is of essence. You cannot say that, oh, all the channels have gone live with this, but I'm going to hold on. But we do have to hold on. You know, we do have to hold on sometimes to the news before releasing it, because there is immense challenge in just putting out everything that is coming your way onto air, especially for broadcast, you know. I think it's a big, big challenge. So I think social media has realized it, and as Milind was saying, that there are, you know, ways and processes they're building into their algorithm which says this is fake news checked, and this is verified, this is authenticated. But there was no need for that if they would not have gotten into a space where they did not have the right experience and relevance.
Lorena, your case going from print to jump to an online, and what kind of challenges or opportunities have you witnessed since then?
Well, actually, I always like to think about possibilities. No, currently I'm in India because I joined as a speaking person from Latin America a global peace campaign which is called Jai Jagat. And we make this as a global campaign just because of media, just because of the possibility that this platform provides us. You know, yes, this campaign is a walk from India to Geneva in the framework of Mahatma Gandhi values of peace and justice. But now we are using these tools to make the information spread all around and to make a global campaign.
Milind, for you, you and Prerna, the difference is that they have a lot of advertisers' pressure, and which you don't have. So is your does that help your digital first thing in any way? Is that an advantage of being in that position?
So I don't think that advertising has anything to do with the digital first, if you ask me. Because as a journalist, as I told you, the user has already moved to digital. So whether, I mean, advertisers are also moving. So whether your revenue model or your business model is public funded or, and
also the kind of content you will create and the content they will create would also fundamentally differ, because there are certain different pressures, you know, working in the newsroom.
I don't think so that, you know, I mean, there was a clickbait which was, say, there for 5 years ago. But now everybody realizes that the clickbait cannot take you far. So people are looking at the engagement of that article when people click, how much time they are spending. And that's how the algorithm are also being built. So I think, because now this is not something just an extension of, this is something new. For India Today, it was a magazine, it is a TV, and it is now on digital. So the experience has to be for everybody, has to be the same. So it's not that, you know, you can push something else on digital. So maybe everybody was doing it 5 years ago, but nobody is doing it anymore, because people realize that the brand experience has to be same at the all the platform. So, you know, just to coming back to your point, that we journalists might say that, you know, it is because of the advertising, it is because of political pressure. But as a journalist, my job is to get digital first. You know, like, I have to get my digital skills in place. I cannot have any excuses that I'm doing it, oh, because of this, oh, because of that. The fact is that users are changing and we need to change.
Prerna, virality is like very important now, this term, you know, this will go viral. They were saying in the earlier panel also. Does that drive the digital first content also in newsrooms? Like, how do you...
I think virality is a concept which kind of transgressed from the digital space into the television space. So it's not the other way around. It was when people started looking at content, and when you got the first-hand feedback of something, you know, instant two-way communication was what digital brought to the table, because television was a monologue, right? and it wasn't meant for the kind of Gen Z and millennial audiences we are talking about now. They want to engage, they want to interact, they want to tell you. They don't just want to know about things, they want to be known. So, you know, you will see that on the digital platform, the engagement level is such that the moment you put some content, you get instant feedback and you realize that, okay, the audiences are kind of playing with this, toying with this idea today. We want to take it on to television. So you see, we have come a long way from digital first to the repercussions of digital first, because we are feeding a lot of information from the digital and social media into our broadcast, which is a flip. And that's where we are different from the rest of the world, because we have so much of content happening on digital, which is going back onto the broadcast space. So, you know.
So, before I come to you, my final question to all of you. Are there any best practices of digital first that you would like to sum up, all of you, one by one? Okay.
Okay, so, you know, the way we use the term digital first is it's really abused and it's misused. Because for us journalists, I think the most ostensible part of digital first is that put every content in the form of visual medium and digital medium and, you know, audio, voice, video, right? But what I really feel, and I've been in this profession for more than 2 decades, and I've seen this transition in the making, this disruption in the making, and digital is not just the content. Digital first is a methodology. It is a culture in an organization, and your content has to talk back to your marketing, your sales, your teams within the organization. It's a mindset change. It's not just content. So we really, it's a misnomer when we talk about digital first as content, because to me, it is a complete mindset change of the teams who are working on your thing. You know, he was talking about how television and digital and magazine teams have to be different. You know, the biggest challenge for the India Today Group was to actually change the mindset of a magazine which was already the number one. So what do you go and tell the team that you are number one? Why do you want to get into digital? Why do you have to do that? So breaking that mindset and breaking into that culture of a team is digital first for a company.
Lorena.
Well, I'm not going to answer as a journalist, but as a human rights advocate. For me, what brings digital first is a huge opportunity to improve as a society. I feel that we should start thinking in accessible digital first. Si les hablo en español, no me van a entender. This means that if I talk to you in Spanish, you are not going to understand me. In India, there are 25 million deaf people. But in media, there's no subtitles to make the information accessible for them. If I speak to you in Spanish, but I include a subtitle, you can access to the information. It's as easy as that. Small actions can have a huge impact regarding to accessibility. The size of the font, the color, the contrast. We all use social media. We need to include alternative text in each photo that we post. There are like a lot of opportunities that this digital first can bring to us regarding to accessibility and to make information accessible to all of us.
Thanks. Milan, you're...
I would say, I mean, I have worked in a newspaper, I have worked in TV and now digital. I can tell you that the golden rule remains the same, which is your story. So, I mean, whether you have to have a good story to tell, if you don't have a good story to tell, then nobody is going to click on it or watch it. That's point number one. The second point is that how it is different than, say, television and newspaper is it is all about engagement. If you don't talk to your, I mean, like what people are reacting, how they are, and you have to talk back to them. So in television, you just do your show and you go away. In digital, people come back to you and they will give you a comment. Then you have to clarify there or you have to, whatever you talk to them. So engagement is the golden rule of digital. It's not about the, so we Indians are very obsessed with reach, ki ye story has reached 1 million or 10 million. I mean, at BBC, we look at how many people got engaged with the story, how many people have commented on it, how many people have liked it. So I think engagement is what is
should
very
be the real metric.
Real metrics, because otherwise, to is desh mein itni abadi hai ki aapko bahut sare log mil jayenge dekhne wale. Matlab, lekin engage kitne kar rahe hain? Wo, I think that mindset has to change that from the reach to engagement, because you will have good engagement will give you good revenue also. It's not just about
Great, I'm on time. Thank you so much.